Now my children dance in summer rain, and my fields are green again. Raised our neighbor's barns with hands that hold God's blessing inside. And I whisper.
My guitar player has a studio, and we both decided we wanted to work in the mornings till late afternoon, early evening, and actually have a home life and have a marriage and have a family life.
I will shout his name across this place and put amazing back into grace.
She just brings life to this house. I mean, you know, she brings friends into our lives, and I think so many times I can just get so focused on what I'm doing, and she's taught me a lot about living. She's taught me a whole lot about, she has such a capacity for joy. And, you know, I've heard so many people say, well, that, you know, that love for a child, it must be what God feels for us. But for somebody that's never known that love before, you know, I had no idea you could love something so much. And that they just love you. They just accept you. You know, they don't care if you're 2 feet tall or you know, what, I mean, you know, 10 feet tall. They just love you. And it's unconditional. I never knew unconditional love. I've heard people talk about it. But to have someone in your life that just loves you, and the responsibility that you feel to protect and care and to see that they're nurtured.
Am I wrestling with your angels or fighting demons of my own?
It costs me a lot emotionally to choose the kind of songs that I sang and to sing them the way that I sang. You don't just sing a nice little song and, you know, because when I sing, it requires, it demands to be sung. And it costs emotionally. It's emotion. It's raw emotion a lot of times. But that's what moves me. I respond to life and death. That gets my attention. When I sing, when I perform, when I write, all of the things, I go to the same place because then I enjoy it. I don't enjoy just the surface things or to write a nice song, but to write a nice song. You know, it has to be something I believe, something I feel, something I've lived through.
Down my face, be a cry for mercy, a call for grace. Eyes pressed closed to shut out the night. Heart wide open to let in your light.
But the thing that I'm sensing so far is grace and mercy. And I love those two words. I mean, I love what they mean to me. Grace, that unmerited favor that he has toward me, that he just loves me, you know. I remember when my dad passed away last year, and I felt just that loss and that pain. Because there were so many things left unresolved between he and I. In the last several months of his life, I tried to talk with him, but he couldn't go there. He just couldn't go there. But I remember being at his funeral and feeling such a loss that I had a physical father, but I never really had a dad. That I felt like I didn't anyway. You know, my mother may disagree or some friend, but I never felt like, and I left home when I was 17 and never went back. But there was just that little voice after we put him in the ground, that still small voice that just said, let me be your dad. I won't fail you. I'll be there for you. And so here I am, you know, halfway through my life and letting Father God be my father, you know, and learning what that means. And one of the first things I'm learning is that he just accepts me.
He was a good man. He was a good...
I was writing it in a relationship-oriented way. Russ has come out of one of the most profound experiences in his life, which was the loss of his father. And although that wasn't what was foremost in my mind when I was writing that lyric, when he heard it, and particularly when he got in the studio and started singing it, the place it touched in him had to do with those issues. So it was really unusual because there was an intensity in my writing it that was over here, and there was an intensity in his performing it that was over here.
If it moves me, then I know it's got to move, you know, somebody. And that's when I'm writing songs or picking songs for the record or whatever, you know. It's always, it has to be that. Because if I'm being moved by it, surely somebody will be.
Oh, my children.